Hello everyone, this is Dr. Zaidi. Welcome to my YouTube channel, ZTube. In this video, I'll be discussing about keeping or dropping a product line, a segment, a service, a customer, or a department. So the decision that we need to make is, should we discontinue a segment or a product line or a customer or a department that is unprofitable for the company or not, right? Now, the erroneous assumption is that whenever we discontinue a product, whenever we discontinue a segment, right, or a customer or a department, we will be able to eliminate all the costs, all the variable and fixed costs, right? Which is not true. Only the variable cost and the allocated fixed cost can be avoided. The common fixed cost stays there. You are going to incur common fixed cost no matter whatever decision you make. In the short run, you won't be able to avoid common fixed cost. Only the allocated fixed cost will be able to avoid it, and the variable cost associated with a particular product or customer or the department can be avoidable. And your operating income will increase or decrease by the amount of the contribution margin that you are obtaining from that particular product. And we'll see that in the upcoming slides. So here we have three products. We have a product A, product B, and product C. And if you see the income statement of these products is provided below, it shows that product A is profitable, giving you $25 of operating income. Product B is $50, and product C is $50, all right? Product B is $50 loss, and product C is $50 profit. Now the question is, should we discontinue a product B? Because product B is not profitable, we have $50 loss. So if we discontinue that product, we are gonna save that $50 loss, so our income will increase by that amount, right? Now, if you remember what I said before, that only fixed allocated cost can be avoided if the product is discontinued. This is an erroneous assumption that all variable and fixed cost will be avoided. Now, this income statement, as the heading suggests, is the absorption costing income statement. In the absorption costing income statement, fixed and variable cost of goods sold are added together. So are the variable and fixed operating expenses together here. So this includes both variable and fixed costs. So in order to find out whether we should discontinue this product or not, we need to convert the absorption costing income statement first into variable costing income statement, or in a segment margin way. So this is the variable costing income statement. That's how it looks like. Sales minus variable cost is your contribution margin, minus fixed cost is income from operation. So what we did here is we combine all variable costs here and all fixed costs here. So this variable cost right there, it includes the variable manufacturing cost, which is direct material, direct labor, and variable manufacturing overhead. But also it includes the variable operating expenses. And the fixed cost includes fixed manufacturing overhead and fixed operating expenses, okay? So if you look at the statement in the expanded form, this is the same statement, is on the left-hand side, is on the right-hand side, but this is in expanded form here. So sales minus variable cost here is your contribution margin, so same thing here. But we also included here is allocated fixed costs. So fixed costs can be just all kind of fixed costs allocated and the common fixed costs. But here we separated out allocated costs. Now allocated costs are the costs that can be avoided if the segment is discontinued, if the product line is discontinued, customer is discontinued. How is that possible? Like, so for example, if the product manager is in charge of the product line, if the product line is discontinued, you can lay off the manager. So you can save that salary, and the salary can be saved immediately. So that's in the short run, you can avoid that fixed cost. So that's allocated fixed cost, right? Whereas if you have already bought the machine and place and you are leasing for 10 years or 20 years, you may not be able to avoid that fixed cost. So that's a common fixed cost that cannot be avoided. So when you subtract the allocated fixed cost from contribution margin, that will give you a segment or product margin, okay? Then you subtract common fixed costs, will give you income from operations. So now let's convert our absorption costing income statement into variable costing. So here I just converted it myself and I allocated all the variable and fixed costs. This is just for illustration purposes. So you don't have to know at this point that what percent was variable, what percent was fixed in, you know, manufacturing category, what percent of variable, what percent was fixed on your operating expenses category. I just allocated it. So now if you look at that, your operating income is $25 for product A, operating loss is $50 for product B, operating income is $50 for product C. This is a variable costing income statement. And if you see, this is sales minus all variable costs, contribution margin minus all fixed costs is your operating income. So if you look at the operating income, this is the same as what you have in your absorption costing, 25 minus 50 and 50. And here you have same 25 minus 50 and 50. Now you need to decide whether you discontinue your product B or not, because it looks like it is unprofitable. So as I stated earlier, that a product that is that you want to discontinue may not eliminate all fixed costs. Only allocated fixed costs and variable costs can be eliminated, which can be seen by our next slide. So what we do here is we are going to total product A, B, and C. So we created a column here. So we add up all the sales here. So $900 for all three products. All the variable costs are added up here, 455. So 900 minus 455 is 445. And then we added all the fixed costs here, 420. And then this will give you $25. The total profit for the company is $25 for all the products that they are producing. And as you can see here, this 50 and minus 50 can cancel out. You will left with $25. That's what it is showing here, that the company is making $25. Now see what happens when we eliminate product B. So product B is eliminated. You are not going to make the $200 that you were making. So instead of $900 total sales, you're going to have $700. So your sales drop. Obviously, you're not going to incur any variable costs. So instead of, so you will lose that $125. You're not going to incur that $125. So your total variable cost instead of 455 will be 330. 455 minus 125, 330. So your contribution margin will be $370 instead of $445, which was more before. However, you are still going to incur all the fixed costs, right? Initially, you have $145 in product A, $125 in product B, $150 in product C. That was the allocation. The total was $420. Your fixed cost is still going to be $420. The allocation will change. So if you have to allocate $420, this will be allocated between two products, product A and C. So it'll be like a lot more than 145 and a lot more than 150, right? But in total, it will stay same. If it will stay same in total and your operating income is your contribution margin is 370, which is a lot less than 445, you're going to have $50 of net loss. Now this company is suffering even more loss than it was suffering before. Before it was having $25 profitability when all the products are active. Now, when you discontinued product B, which you thought is that you are selling in loss and you're losing $50, you're losing even more, right? So you went from 25 to minus 50, which is a $75 difference. 25 minus 50, that's a $75 difference. So your income from operations dropped by $75. The difference between these two is 75. Dropped by $75. This is the amount of contribution margin of product B. So remember, if a product has a positive contribution margin or a segment margin, right, and you discontinue that product, then your profitability will be reduced by the amount of contribution margin. So the amount of contribution margin was 75 and your profitability is declined by 75. 25 minus 25 minus 75 is minus 50. So discontinuing a product with a positive contribution margin or product margin or segment margin will reduce your operating income by the amount of that contribution margin or a product margin or segment margin. So things to remember, all right? When a product or segment is discontinued, all the variable costs associated with that product and allocated fixed cost associated with that product will be eliminated. Common fixed cost will stay there whether you continue making the product or you discontinue. It cannot be eliminated, right? So therefore, your change in operating income will be determined by your contribution margin, product margin, or segment margin. If you have a positive contribution margin, you discontinue a product, your operating income will be reduced by the amount of that contribution margin, as you have seen in the example before. So our decision, rule of thumb, if contribution margin is greater than zero, or you can say product margin or segment margin is greater than zero, do not discontinue that product, because if you discontinue that product, your income from operation will be reduced by the amount of contribution margin. On the other hand, if contribution margin is less than zero, then you can discontinue that product because that will generate or bring more income to the company. If contribution margin is zero, equal to zero, or product margin is equal to zero, then you are indifferent. That's your decision whether you want to continue making the product or not, right? Sometimes you have to consider the subjective reasons for why you continue making a product, right? So maybe if it's a complementary product, even if the contribution margin is negative, product margin is negative, you may continue making the product. You know, let's take an example of a Starbucks coffee. When you go, you buy a coffee, whether you, and you know, you buy a regular hot coffee, right? And, you know, a tall size hot coffee. Whether you put creamer in it or you put sugar in it, you still pay the same amount of coffee. So if two people go and they buy the same coffee and one adds creamer to it, the other one adds creamer and sugar to it, and you know, they will pay the same amount. So the cost of sugar and creamer are paid by Starbucks. That's the extra cost that they are incurring. So if they discontinue keeping creamer and sugar just because they're incurring extra costs, they may lose sale of the coffee. There's some customers who just only drink coffee with the creamer and sugar, they are going to stop coming to that. They are only coming because they provide the other stuff too, even though that stuff does not bring profitability for the company. So sometimes you have to think about the qualitative measure or subjective measure. Why do you want to keep that product even if the product is not profitable? Example, Z Beverages manufactures V-Cola in its San Diego plant. A condensed income statement for V-Cola is provided below. So you have sales, 500,000. You have a cost of goods sold. That's total 300,000. That includes both variable manufacturing cost or variable cost of goods sold and fixed manufacturing cost or fixed cost of goods sold, which is fixed MOH, right? Gross profit is 200,000. Operating expenses are 250,000, out of which 20% are fixed, 80% are variable. So currently, V-Cola is giving company a loss of $50,000. Again, remember that. The product is in loss, but this income statement is provided in an absorption costing format. You cannot conclude that whether discontinuing this product will bring a loss for the company or a profit for the company. In income statement shows that V-Cola is not profitable for the company. Z is evaluating whether the V-Cola should be discontinued or not, since it is one of the many colas that Z Beverages Incorporated manufactures. Discontinuing V-Cola will not affect fixed costs. So it clearly says that if you discontinue a product, there is no allocated fixed cost associated with it. So all the costs are common fixed costs because they cannot be affected if you discontinue a product. So all the fixed costs stay there. Now, should Z discontinue V-Cola? Why or why not? Let's jump into the solution now. So now, cost of goods sold was 300,000. And as you can see from the question, 90% is variable, 10% is fixed. So we separate out 90% of 300,000, 270, 10% is 30,000. Then operating expenses, it says 80% are variable. So we separated out variable, 80% times 250,000, 200, fixed $50,000, which is 20% of 250,000. So in the event, if you discontinue this product, you may not avoid this 30,000 in fixed cost of goods sold and 50,000 in fixed operating expenses. That's total of $80,000 that is going to stay there. So let's make an income statement and see. So the sales was 500,000, right? Given variable cost of goods sold, we just calculated previously 270,000. This will give you manufacturing margin of 230,000. Then we subtracted variable operating expenses, 200,000. That was right here. We calculated 80%. So 200,000, this will give us 30,000 of contribution margin. Okay. Then we have fixed cost of goods sold, 30,000. Right there, fixed manufacturing overhead, 30,000. And fixed operating expenses, 50,000. So the total fixed cost is 80,000. Now this is common fixed cost. So now, when you subtract 80 from 30, you're getting 50,000 loss from operation, which is same as here, loss from operation. But you're not going to look at this loss. What you're going to look for is the contribution margin, right? Or contribution margin minus allocated fixed cost, which is in this case, there is none. So contribution margin is positive, which suggests what? If you discontinue a product, your income from operations will be reduced by the amount of that contribution margin, which is 30,000. So right now you were, you know, whatever loss you had, you will lose $30,000 more if you discontinue this product. So this product is not giving a giving company a loss. In a differential format, this is how it looks like. Sales is 500,000, variable cost of goods sold 270,000, variable operating expenses 200,000. So 470,000 is the total differential cost of V-Cola. If you don't produce it, right, you're not going to incur that. But at the same time, you have a differential income. You're not going to make that 30,000 either. So the company will suffer loss. The operating income of the company will drop by 30,000 because that's the contribution margin the company has. If you discontinue a product, contribution margin, your operating income will drop by 30,000 by the amount of contribution margin. That completes this question. Thank you for watching my video. Please subscribe my channel for live updates.